Hi, I'm Tiffany London. I'm a Pennsylvania Fish and Boat Commission fishing skills instructor and owner of Farm Girl Graphics. Here today, we are going to draw another wonderful fish found in Pennsylvania waters. And if you couldn't tell already, we are going to draw a crappie. I have chosen to show you how I draw on my iPad. So all of this is drawn on my iPad. You won't be seeing my hand or paper or any of that other mediums that we've used in the past drawings. So this is how I draw most of my final decals that I do and logos and things like that. So if you have an electronic notebook that you've been wanting to draw on, this is a good time to try it. And if you don't, just grab some markers, crayons, whatever you'd like to use, and just follow along. So one of my favorite things about drawing on my iPad is I can add all of my base colors and then I can go back on top and add the detail, and I don't have to wait for any paint to dry. I don't have to worry about smearing any markers, and it's a very fun process, especially watching it in time lapse. So fill in the base colors and remember to slow down or pause the video if you need. Don't get overwhelmed. The time lapse makes it seem like I can draw these in 5 minutes, but don't worry. Take your time and just have fun. Okay, now for the fun part, we're going to add the spots, scales, and tail designs here. So take your time, and I'm just using a black here on top, and I'm going to use white for the scales on the bottom, and then go and fine tune the rest of the fish with a black outline. Another thing I like to do when I'm getting ready to draw these fish and to do these videos, I like to do some research. I have not fished for crappie and I've not eaten crappie. So after some research, I'm thinking I would like to go out and do both of those things. So for the crappie, it's a freshwater fish. It's a part of the sunfish family, which you can see it greatly resembles a bluegill. They also have several other names. They could be called a strawberry bass, a calico bass, a speckled bass, and a paper mouth. They are more active in the day and evening, so if you're going out in the summer, you're going to want to fish early morning or in the evening. Also, you can fish for this species spring, summer, and even winter. So in the spring, they're going to be more in the shallows and the grasses on the side. As it gets hotter, they're going to move to deeper sections, and they're active in the winter, so if you want to go ice fishing, you know how to ice fish, you can even fish for this species in the winter, which is something I might be able to try, especially when I get cold and tired after chasing those steelhead up in Erie. So, okay, that's all I can tell you about the crappie, and we're gonna do the fins here and fine-tune the rest and be finished. And I hope you are having as much fun as I am learning about all the species of fish we have here in Pennsylvania and drawing them and getting out and fishing and teaching others to fish and taking your kids out there. I hope everyone is having a great summer as we wind down here, and stay safe and tight lines. Thank you again to Pennsylvania Fish and Boat Commission for asking me to do these fish species series, and I will see you soon.